weather's not very good for this. It's night night? Oh my god. You're in luck, Nina. This is like the best day of your life. These people are all gonna be in armor. You're in armor. They're gonna think that you're one of them. Hello, my friends, and welcome back to the Nightmare Legacy Challenge. I was going to like speed through the night and start the video in the morning, but the second I opened up the save, a sewage leak popped up. So now I have to deal with that. I don't even know where it is. We had this problem last episode where like gross green stuff. Look, ew. I think I'll just replace it. Who are you? Excuse me? There was just a stranger in the house for a second. Okay, well, there's still like stinky gross puddles down here again, but we'll deal with that later. We've not been having too many maintenance problems here in this house, but I've been having a lot of sewage problems specifically. And I mean, of course the fire stuff, but let's just ignore that part, okay? Just don't think about that too much. And the plan for today's episode, I think, is mostly just to get Tinker aged up and then to do all of their new outfits and redo their bedroom and like kind of start thinking about the next generation, maybe start voting on an heir. All of that sort of stuff has to be done because we're kind of getting to the point where it's time to move on. Also, unfortunately, our grandparents gonna be super dead today. We're gonna have probably more than one death in this episode. The person is back. Oh, it's Javier. Oh, that's our cousin. I was wondering who that person was. I was like, did I invite you here or are you just standing there? He's just standing there, but at least he's related to us. It's not as bad as like some random guy. Oh, the sewage water is gone. Oh, did it like seep into the floor? Uh-oh, sorry about the basement. That can't be a good sign for you, Belle. That's okay. I can deal with it. I probably should make everybody else get up because I've kind of failed to get us ready for school here and that's not good. Yeah, we have to go like right now, but I want to try and fix our fun need first. If I can just get it up like a little bit more in the green. Here, go. Bye. You too. Off to grade school in a literal blizzard. Wow. That's lovely. You're not even wearing a coat. What is wrong with you? That's your own fault. I don't know what to tell you. You could have changed. And yet, here we are. Okay, wow, off to a good start. What is that, like strike four for this household and it's been like 3 minutes? Oh my god. All right, let me quick just delete some of this Christmas decor as well while we're sitting here and like put the living room back together. Little May is also going to age up today, so I think I might start there and have one of the Sims come bake us a cake. Oh, you can flirt with the fridge? Oh, Nina, go do that. Let's try it. Okay, well, I'll bake a hamburger cake and we'll get the kid aged up first. Do you think that she can like actually have a relationship with the fridge? Oh, look, she's feeling so flirty. That's so cute. Oh, we should find Nina love. Oh, it doesn't have to be another machine. We could like fall in love with a person. Hold on, should I make a club? How about the club icon is this video game thing? What if we tried to find an alien? I was gonna say we could try and find someone who like likes games, likes computers, but I'm not too picky. I think an alien would be really fun, but I wouldn't be surprised if that didn't work out for us. Who is Vaughn? What about Yuki? Or like Savannah, one of the other old townies? Eliza Pancakes. What if she falls in love with Eliza Pancakes and then Eliza dies? This person's a firefighter. I think it'd be weird if we tried to date Vaughn, even if he's not like biologically related to us. I don't know. Nina's like part of the family, so she can't date one of the cousins. That'd just be weird. I know she's a robot and like maybe it'd be cute, but I don't know. It's kind of icky, so I can't do that. Is no one gonna come help me? I tried to ask all of these Sims to help me clear up all this stuff downstairs and not a single one has come to help me. The fridge always has stinky stuff in it. Help. Okay, Nina, let's add some birthday candles to this cake and then we can age up the baby. Finally, finally we are. Oh, I pressed the wrong Sim. I just tried to age up Javier. I didn't know he was still there. Oh no, I just ruined the aging. I'm sorry. Uh-oh. I think that Javier is April's nephew. Or is Javier, no, Javier is April's cousin. Eh, he can be our age, that's fine. I really did mess that up. I'm sorry. I don't know why I pressed age up Sim instead of help blow out candle. And I don't know why I just went ahead and like clicked it. I didn't think about it. I didn't read it. I just kind of went for it and then it was too late. But it's fine. He'll be fine. He might be older now than like his older siblings, but that's okay. I don't really play with that Sim, so it doesn't matter. Just don't think about it too much. Okay, we are officially aging up the final little one of this legacy generation. Okay, I usually randomize their traits. So May is going vegetarian. Oh, that's good. And we could have like the slumber party animal aspiration or something. I should probably do May's outfits real quick too. huh? Before I forget. And then I have to redo her room. Oh, we have so much to do today. Okay, we need like a full-on house renovation, basically. So here is little May. I might give her like, I don't know, what's one of the hairs that I haven't used in a while? I used to love this hairstyle. I haven't used that in a bit. This happens to me a lot where I'll like find a hair that I really like and then I'll use it all the time. And then I kind of like think that I use it all the time, so I stop using it. And now it's been like probably a couple years. But I don't know. Back when it came out, this was a fave for me. I like the little clips. I think they're kind of cute. We can do this one. Let's do this one. And then I'll dress her in blue so it kind of matches. Oh, this was like a go-to for me. This combo, because they're both from Parenthood. I was using this all the time. That's actually really good though. Like, look at that, come on. I'll give her a little bracelet. Do you wanna wear glasses maybe? I'm being picky about the color of the glasses is the problem. I don't know, I'll leave it for now. We can always get glasses later. It's not like we're stuck with this, you know? It's not like this is the only time we're gonna be in Cass. Okay, so here's her little formal outfit. I got a cute blue dress. For our athletic wear, I might use these little shorts because they match. Are there any fun, like this tank top's kind of cute? Or we could do something more plain with the stripes. I don't know. There's also some shorts that have more pattern to it. Oh, that's better. Let's try that. Not that it matters. Again, it's just athletic wear. My Sims barely ever use this, but it's still good to have. Look at her little sleepwear. It's so matching. That's so cute. I always like to give my Sims socks to sleep too. I know this is kind of controversial, but I wear socks to sleep. I wear socks pretty much always. So I'm gonna give my Sim some socks as well. Oh, look at this little dress. I like that with the blue flowers because it matches her hair. Okay, that's cute. And then here's our swimwear. Here's our little hot weather outfit. I know I'm really embracing the blue thing. I'm sorry. If there's one thing about me, it's that I'm gonna give my Sims a color theme. Without fail, every single time. My Sims have like a full-on color theme happening, but I'm not mad about it. I think it's kind of cute. Maybe we could have like a more patterned boot. Oh, no. No, not camo. Okay, I don't like that. Does this tuck in? Maybe that's better. Is that cuter? It is winter, so we need this. This is like kind of important. How about that? We can just do simple. Okay, so here's all of May's outfits. She's got her everyday, our formal, our athletic, sleepwear, party wear, swimwear, hot weather, and cold weather. I'm also gonna randomize her some likes and dislikes quick too. So she likes white, and I'll say she likes blue as well, clearly. She likes alternative music. She apparently likes hardworking Sims. She hates complaining. And she also hates horse riding. Oh, she hates horses. Okay, well that's fine. I don't have a horse. And you won't be getting a horse. That's just not gonna happen. We live in a townhouse. There's not really like room for that right now. Okay, we're back. Hello? You're done with school for the day? Can I ask why? It's 12:45. Did you lose school performance from this because you ditched school early? I didn't bring the kids home. That wasn't me. I just went into Cass. That's all. Oh, great. Here, can you add some birthday candles to this? I was gonna spend the afternoon trying to get my robot a girlfriend. Oh my god. You know what, Javier? I am not your biggest fan right now. The fact that you just ate my cake seconds before I finished putting the candles on makes me want to cry. Okay, let's try again. I'm just gonna age up Tinker. I'll just do it now so we can get it over with. And then maybe this evening we can go out and try and find Nina a girlfriend. We'll spend our night doing that. Nina doesn't have to sleep, so she could very easily stay up late if she wanted to. I'm also making Belle do this for her sibling because my teens have like no skills. So I'm kind of, oh no. Oh, here it comes. Yeah, Jasmine has passed away. Okay, it's only a matter of time till the next one comes in. Not a job offer, leave me alone. Oh, this hurts. Our grandmother is dead. Did you even finish baking the cake or did you get distracted? Oh no, you finished. Okay, sorry. I was gonna say, your grandma dying is actually like not a bad reason to not finish baking a cake, but you do have to finish for me. Oh no. August, Jasmine's partner. Yeah, it's a matter of time. We're gonna get a call any second, I bet. Happy birthday, Tinker. Sorry about your grandparents. This is rough timing for you. Oh, the cat is right in the candles. That cannot be good. This is such a legacy challenge image with the cat and the robot. Cat's face right in the fire and everything. Of course it is. Of course it is. All right, come on. Why are you sad? Shared sadness. Oh, great. Double sad? That's horrible. And now you've gone out into the blizzard again to age up. Okay. I really would honestly like for Tinker to be the heir. So this trait randomization is a big deal because this is kind of like a game changer for us. So Tinkerbell is going to have the trait good. Good and lazy. Okay.
Okay.
I was thinking about trying to do some sort of handiness thing, like maybe the nerd brain one, because tinker, we can try and like craft stuff. In the same sense, like maybe the maker thing could be interesting and we could become a fabricator because we haven't really done that. But I might do a teen aspiration first, just because while we're young, we might as well try this. I might pick the goal-oriented one so we can try and like rise and grind a little bit. So Tinker has the pack animal trait. We didn't get any bonus traits apparently. Okay, that's fine. I'm gonna go into Cass so we can do all of their outfits. So this is what Tinker looks like. Oh my god, they are cute. Just so you know, Tinker uses they, them pronouns. Obviously we canceled that a long time ago. And they also wear eyeball rings, apparently. I'm gonna have to do some thinking here to figure out what hairstyle to use. I'm kind of leaning towards something short. I really like this cottage living one, actually. That's an idea, I'm gonna save that. I don't know about, oh, okay, never mind, not that one. I don't know. I always have a hard time trying to pick a hairstyle. I think it's partially because I keep my Sims hairs for like most of their lives. So once I pick one, it kind of ends up being what I stick with. So it feels very high pressure trying to decide. This one's kind of cool too. That's also from Eco Lifestyle, and we're gonna do a lot of Eco Lifestyle stuff. What if we had green hair? Thoughts on green hair? Even if only temporarily, like as a teen, if we had green hair, I might also give us some teeth and then maybe like a skin detail. Give us teeth is a very weird way of describing that, but I put a gap in their teeth. Okay, well, I don't really want to have green leg hair. No offense. I don't think I'm super interested in that. I think just brown will probably do. I'm kind of realizing by accident right now that this sim is very similar to my current Not So Berry challenge air, because I'm on the green gen of Not So Berry right now, but I named the sim Tinkerbell, so I have to have them wear green. Like, that's just, it's necessary. That's like the whole thing. Okay, so this is kind of what I'm thinking for their outfit, at least for their everyday wear. I got some kind of interesting green pants and this cute werewolf shirt. I also put the non-binary pride flag nails on. Okay, so I think that this will be our everyday outfit, at least for now, but I'll probably go back in and give us some more. Okay, here's the formal outfit I picked. It's like a green suit. It looks kind of weird with the shade of their hair, because the green of their hair is like totally different, but I'm not mad about it. I think it's fine. Wow. Interesting choice of athletic wear. I probably wouldn't have picked that myself. We don't have to be like green green. I just think it's fun to have some green. Okay, I said that and then I picked a green shirt, but I still like it. Like, I still think it works. Oh, these are fun for our sleepwear. I don't really normally use these. Let's try that. Maybe we could find some like funky green socks too. Oh, never mind. No, never mind, sorry. Plain socks. Plain socks are better. I think I'll use the same nail polish for all of our outfits too, because there's no point in doing anything fancy. And there's also no point in taking off the nail polish for bed. Like, they probably would have it across all of their outfits. Werewolves has like some shockingly good casts. Casts that like, at least maybe I didn't expect I would like this much. And so it's kind of fun for me to use for stuff like this, because look at how cute that shirt is. We can do the green pants again. I kind of like them together actually. Okay, so how about this for our party wear? I really like how the pants match some of the patches on the little shirt. I'm actually kind of struggling with swimwear for this sim. I'm trying to decide what would be fun. I kind of like the carrot t-shirt. Maybe if we had the carrot t-shirt and then some like swim shorts, that's simple enough. And then we can wear some slides that kind of match the carrots or something. I don't know. I like that carrot shirt. That's from the new Home Chef Hustle Pack. It's kind of cute to just have a shirt that's got carrots on it. I don't know. It speaks to me. And then for our hot weather outfit, wait, I'm actually kind of loving the bucket hat vibe. Maybe I can try and find a swatch that would work for this. This one's kind of fun with the green and the purple. Let me see if I can make that work, because maybe I could have a little purple shirt. I'm looking for like a lighter purple, or a purple that at least matches the tone of the hat a bit better. And none of these are really speaking to me. I'm not really obsessed. Maybe there's purple pants. There's a lot of skirts and a lot of shorts and stuff, but they're not really what I'm going for. I would argue that just because it's hot outside does not mean that we have to wear shorts. We can still wear pants. I speak to you as a person who lives in Florida who does wear pants in the summer sometimes. Do these look really kind of hot? Yeah. Yeah, they do. But also, Tinker looks kind of hot in them, so it's fine. It works. Oh, there's a horse. Okay. You know who would hate that? Our sister, who apparently hates horses. Oh no. None of the greens are working. Not a single one of them is working. Maybe it should just be white. Oh. Maybe this could be fun. Because that matches. It fits with the pants still. I think that's okay. Maybe if we had some green shoes to like tie it all together or something. I don't know. Oh, yikes. Okay, actually all the shoes that are green are kind of scary. So I might just do plain white shoes. This is a very different vibe from our like other outfits. Maybe it's bad. We're kind of giving like cottagecore for our other outfits. I'm sorry. I don't know what's gotten into me. I don't know what I'm doing. I just love the hat. I want to use the hat, but nothing matches the hat. What if I embrace the cottagecore thing? Oh, this is way better. This looks way more like something they would wear. I'm sorry. I don't know what got into me there. I was trying to do something different. It wasn't gonna work. We have to find a different sim who can wear that, because that was cute, the hat and stuff. I just don't think that it looks like something they would wear. Maybe when May ages up. Maybe May could wear it instead. That would work. Okay, and last for our cold weather outfit, this is kind of what I'm leaning for their cold weather. And then I think that should be all of our outfits done. So we have our everyday wear, our formal, our athletic, sleepwear, party wear, swimwear, hot weather, and cold weather. We've got some kind of fun stuff going on. I like this sim. I think Tinker is actually really cool. Okay, we're gonna have to redo the bedroom, but I will say I might do that off camera just because I don't really know if I want to build right now. I don't know if I can bring myself to do that, so I might set it up in time for next episode. Although, I don't know what to do. Part of me is like, what if May just takes over this bedroom? Like, what if May uses this room and we kind of swap them out a little bit? Because this room could stay, because I really, really like the color scheme in here and I don't really want to get rid of it. And then maybe Tinker could have this room. I don't know if they deserve that, because it's quite small, but also, Tinker probably is going to be the heir. I'm kind of leaning towards that. So if they're going to have like their whole own house, do they really need the biggest room in this house? No, probably not. I think they can handle it. This kind of has that cute cottagecore thing that we were talking about with this like little quilt on it. Maybe that could be fun for us to use. Oh God, this is dangerous. If I start doing build mode right now, we're never gonna stop. Also, that horrible like putrid green with the purple window is so weird. I'm sorry. I can see it. I know it's weird. Oh my gosh. What about that? Isn't that cute though? With the mushrooms? That makes me think that this bed does not work anymore. I want to like it, but it's kind of maybe too much. We could do something a bit plainer. This is the same bed, but in just plain green. We could also do a double bed, because I usually like to give my teenage Sims double beds in their bedrooms. My worry right now is that if I use this, it's like too much green in a bad way. And I kind of feel like I need to mix and match in some other colors. Maybe this is too much. Maybe the cottagecore thing is a bad idea. See, this is the problem. I don't have the energy in me to do a whole build right now. I might have to fix this and then show you next week. It might be the only way, because I could sit here and do this for like 2 hours and that sounds dangerous. Okay, what I do want to do, I'm sorry to just ditch you, Tinker, because you just aged up, but I feel really committed to trying to find Nina a girlfriend, so I might go work on that now, although her durability is really bad. Nina, here, self-repair, okay? You work on that. Maybe this evening we'll head out. Let me put everything away while I wait, and then maybe this might be a good time for us to, like, do some homework. They want to do their homework 5 times for the aspiration, so I guess I'll just start there. They also want to join an after-school activity, and that's, like, you know, not ideal. But I can try. I can try. You'll have to let me know in the comments before I get my hopes up too high and get too attached to this sim. Are you feeling what I'm feeling about Tinker being the heir? Because I kind of am. That's kind of how I've been feeling since they were only a child. So let me know. We'll do like a community gauge of how we're all feeling. Especially because now that they're a teen, we can actually see their outfits. It might be best to hold off until May ages up to make any final decisions, but they have 7 days. So that's kind of a long time to wait and decide. Just let me know. We'll chat in the comments and then we'll come back next week and have a better idea of what's going on. That wasn't too bad at all, actually, because Nina's pretty much fixed. Her durability's already back up. Okay, so I say that we join Scouts because I think that's like probably the most appropriate for this sim. Although, are you kidding? Upstairs? Where's the fire? Oh my God, the kettle? Well, don't just stand there. Extinguish it. Hello? What is wrong with you? You're just gonna stand there and no one's gonna do anything about it? I haven't seen the kettle catch fire yet. Oh, I actually can't do anything. All right, we gotta wait for the firefighters. What if they can't get to it either? What if they also just stand there? Hello? Come in. Oh, what's wrong with you? Here we go. My savior. You're walking under the stairs? Oh, this is Kenji. Anybody? They haven't done anything yet. Hello? Hello? These people suck! They don't even do their job! Okay, never mind. Sorry, it's back. Well, that didn't even break any of my stuff. No, I'm sorry. That doesn't make any sense.
sense.
This game makes no sense. Okay, Tinkerbell did join the Scouts. That doesn't count for this aspiration, but I'm just gonna say that it does, okay? Because I feel like it should, and we can work on our scouting badges. I don't know why, I don't know what's going on. I'm just gonna leave. I don't wanna be here right now. I'm just gonna send Nina out. She hasn't been out on her own a single time. So this can be kind of fun for her. We can go out like Nina's big day. We'll see if we can make some friends. If you could go anywhere, and you're literally a robot, where would you go? Maybe for like one of the occult bars, like in Moonwood Mill, there's the Grimtooth Bar and Bunker where other occult sims go. And a robot's like kind of an occult sim, right? I don't really know. It kind of depends how you look at it. I'm not really sure. Oh, the weather's not very good for this. It's night night? Oh my God. You're in luck, Nina. This is like the best day of your life. These people are all gonna be in armor. You're in armor. They're gonna think that you're one of them. Also, this is Yuki. This is the sim that I was thinking about maybe trying to date. I just like Yuki and I kind of like the idea of dating a townie, but now I'm wondering if I should date one of the other occult sims. Who's that? Dwayne? Annalise Bell, that's family. Liz, oh, we know Liz because my sims went to college with her, but she has a wife, so we can't do that. Did you just scan her? Oh my God. Maker, loner, and geek. She's a maker too? And she's a geek and she's a loner. So she likes nerdy stuff. She likes making stuff and she doesn't like talking to people. So if someone's gonna date a robot, it's gonna be her. She's perfect for this. Wait, hold on. Discuss interests. Vent maybe? Is that a bad idea? Never mind. Forget the night thing. I wanna date Yuki. Talk about the snow. Talk about cooking. Share photos. Ask about career. I actually don't know what Yuki, maybe ask about career. I don't even know what Yuki does. She's normally a teen, but obviously at this point she's aged up. Okay, she's unemployed. That's fine. I am too, because I'm a robot. So that's fine. Should you guys stargaze together? Is it safe for Nina to lay in the snow? Given that she is a robot, I'm not sure. Look, they're getting along. I think they're in love. Oh, I forgot Nina's unflirty. Ask about romantic interests. Let's try that. It might be okay. Reluctantly embrace. That's probably a bad idea. Go away, Lilith. I'm busy. I'm trying to flirt. Exchange numbers. This is gonna be bad. I'm gonna get home so late at night. My Sims are gonna be in terrible moods. Everything's gonna be a disaster. Oh, low charge. Witnessed crass act. Oh no. Okay, this was a fail. Let's try again in the morning. Let's just go back home. Let's take a break. We'll take a break. We're getting somewhere. We're not quite there yet, but we're getting somewhere. Okay, come here, Nina. Let's just go charge. Everybody else, let's go to bed too. It is really late and we have school tomorrow. Oh, you're cooking something? Oh, you're grilling something. Oh dear. Okay, are you sure? Oh, nothing bad happened. You didn't even eat it. You grilled it and then went and grabbed waffles? Okay, that's fine too. I'm sorry about your room, Tinker. You don't deserve this. Maybe I'll get you a small piece of decor, okay? How about this? Let's put a pride flag up. Oh, I cannot see that at all. Hold on. Let me go into the light so I can see which one I'm trying to pick. I didn't realize you literally cannot tell what that is. I wanted this swatch. Okay, well, as soon as they walk in, I'll be able to see it. It's just that the lights are off. It's really dark in the house, so you can't really tell. What? You can't get in the bed? No way. Hello? No, no. Go back. Come on. Surely you can get in the bed. Yeah, I was gonna say, there's no way. All right, everyone's asleep. We've made it through another day. You are doing very badly here. Come use the bathroom and take a shower quick before you like pee on the floor. Okay, it is a Friday, so we'll have a lovely day of school today. And then potentially after school, we can try and do some meeting of people because I would like for Tinker to meet some friends as well. Thankfully, Belle has a couple friends, so we should be able to like introduce her to the people that we know, like McKenna, Judith Ward's daughter. It's nice to know some rich people. Oh, I just realized I didn't put Tinker's hearing aids back. This is the problem. I wish that they like aged up with them in cast because I forgot to add that. Okay, let me just quick go through and put the hearing aid back on. If you didn't know, we got an update. At this point, it was like a full year ago with a medical wearables category in cast. And it's got a couple things. We have the hearing aids. We also have some things like some glucose monitors and stuff in there. So it's kind of a nice feature. I'm hopeful they'll add some more stuff like that in the future. Okay, well, everybody is kind of starting to wake up. How terrible would it be if I ditched them before school? I really shouldn't have Nina go out and try and date before we have anybody do anything. What if I just try though? Realistically, who's more important? The living Sims or the robot? Obviously the robot. Come on. Oh, it is May's first day of school though. What? Why are you down here? Did we sleep in the wrong bed? What happened?
See, Yuki wants to go to Von Haunt Estate. This is one of those lots that's really gonna benefit from the castle kit. I think we could redo it and make like a really cool castle out in Windenburg to replace this particular lot. Von Haunt Estate is sort of like it's like a museum, but it's a specialty lot type and it's like a big old manor. But how cool would it be if there was a castle here? Because they have all the grounds out here too. I think that would be so fun. So I might have to go and do something like that once the pack comes out. The castle kit is coming out tomorrow, so stay tuned because I should have some fun videos coming out with it. Okay, I'm tense because I'm suffocated by friendship. What? Because you have the close-knit lifestyle and you have too many friends. Your friends are your family. I'm deleting that. I'm sorry. I'm not dealing with that. I find that really annoying. I don't want to have that lifestyle. No, Yuki's bored. No, 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 no. Stop, stop, stop. Why? What is boring about me? I'm a robot. There's nothing boring about robots. I'm trying to tell some jokes to see if that might help us instead. Owner grace period. Oh, because the lease is up. Oh, we're going to get paid in a minute. I kind of forgot that we owned an apartment. We haven't really talked to the tenants in a little bit. Oh, I embrace it. It worked. Do it again. Okay, she thinks it's awkward. Oh, never mind. We're embarrassed now. Oh, look at her when she's embarrassed. That's so cute. Nina, I love you. I'm doing my best to help you. Are you guys watching me flirt right now? Oh, no wonder I'm embarrassed. What if I just helped her a little bit? Because I can reprogram her traits. It's very easy for me to do that. What if she just decides today she is romantic? I mean, like, this is the magic of playing with a robot. You can switch the traits whenever you need them to be switched. We always thought we were unflirty until we fell in love with Nina. Granted, oh, sorry. Oh my God, it's awkward. Stop, stop, be careful. I was gonna say, we probably shouldn't say we're in love. Like, we met her yesterday, you know? We might be getting a little bit ahead of ourselves, but I just love it, okay? I love the idea, and it's not going that well, but... No, she left me! Oh, man. Come back. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, Eliza's dead? Oh, I thought it was gonna be my family. It's just Eliza pancakes. It's fine. You know who else is gonna die probably today? Betty, the cat. Me not being at home is probably gonna prolong the cat's life, though. Like, as long as I don't go back there, we'll probably be okay. Can you stop doing that? Oh, I can't wait till Thornbailey dies. I'm looking forward to that day, and I mean it. Why do I keep flying away? Go back! Oh my God, Nina, you are making this so difficult for me. I'm gonna try and bring her with me though. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that, everybody. I had to take a small little detour just then to finish yesterday's video. There's been a base game update today, and the patch notes finally came out, so I had to finish a little section about that. I'm gonna send my Sims back home though, because I was gonna try and finish dating Yuki. That's my main goal today. Hopefully she does not ditch me this time. Oh, I think she's feeling flirty. Okay, this could be good actually. Talk to her. Don't just stand there. Come on. What's wrong with you? On the fritz from low durability? Oh, liar. Hold on. Sometimes you have to cheat in The Sims 4 and that's okay. Sometimes it matters most that you're able to get a girlfriend. Guys, I think she's in love with me. Arthur, not now. Leave me alone. First kiss, first kiss, first kiss. What do you think happens when you kiss a robot? I'm actually kind of scared of this. I don't know what to expect. Oh, well, that's nice. Okay, good for you. Come back. Don't leave me again. Woo, and a hot tub. That's gonna kill my Sim. Why would you even say that? No, ask to be girlfriend instead. She said yes. Okay, well, we're definitely not gonna be woohooing in any hot tubs. That is very silly. I also will not be proposing. That seems like a really bad idea. Well, maybe I will. What if I just did? What do you think's gonna happen? I'm kind of scared. Oh, no. No way she said yes. Hold on, let me get a screenshot. I want to be able to see that ring and everything. Are you kidding me? You met me today. We've been together for 2 seconds. That's okay. Robots have to move fast. Whoa. Nina just got engaged to Yuki. Why are the options to woohoo in the shower and in the hot tub? I'm not doing that. That is a ridiculous suggestion and a dangerous suggestion. Now I'm kind of scared that Nina's gonna autonomously get in the hot tub. I don't trust her. Should Belle invite over classmate Courtney? Yeah. Who's Courtney? I'd love to know. Okay, everybody's home and everybody's really upset. The big worry now is that the cat could die literally any second, and I don't want to deal with that. It makes me feel upset just thinking about it. I think I may end the episode here though and save Friday night for next time, because then we can try and have some sort of like teen event and hang out with the other kids from school. I would like for Tinker to maybe go and meet some people and then spend the whole weekend working on our scout badges. What? No! You wait, wait. Yuki, you want to live with my robot? No, no, no. No, No. I don't trust Yuki. I cannot have Nina getting hurt. It's not the right time. I cannot have Yuki live with me, first of all. That's no way. No how, no way. Now she's gonna be mad at me. Well, that's not fair. Residency rejection and not close enough. No, we are not close enough. We are just not close enough. And mostly, I don't want Nina to leave me. I need her. Nina is my best friend. I just can't have her ditch me like this. I'm not ready for her to go away yet. Okay. Well, I think, oh, here's Courtney. I like your makeup. That's cool. Well, I'll get to know you, I guess. I may as well. And then like I was saying, now is probably a good time for me to actually end the episode before I get too far ahead of myself. So in the comments, like I was saying earlier, let me know who we're feeling right now for the air, just so I can kind of gauge the community's reaction. And then stay tuned because next time I'll do this bedroom off camera and we'll have it like all beautiful and set up for next week. I'm gonna make something perfect, especially if Tinker is gonna be the air because they deserve the world, so I'll make it beautiful. And then I guess we can also start planning a wedding for my robot. If I do that, am I gonna need to build an extra bedroom? Is Yuki gonna have to live with me? Can robots have children? Like, these are all very important questions that we kind of have to figure out an answer to. So we'll approach that next time. Thank you for watching. Have the best rest of your day, and I'm gonna catch you all tomorrow, okay? Bye, everybody. Oh, and tomorrow we get the new kit. I'm so excited to play with castles. You guys have no idea. I actually cannot wait.